worked closely with a colleague at Carnegie Mellon named Paul Fishbeck, and he's a very close friend of mine, and we did a lot of work together. And he really likes being on the news, so we had a couple of projects where we were on the national news and so being part of that national news cycle is very, very interesting. We had a thing on traffic fatalities. We had a website where you could go look up your traffic risks, and so I was on, you know, Fox News talking about traffic risks and on NPR talking about traffic risks. And so that was, you know, it was surreal, really, to have your stuff you're doing in your own professional life, you know, sort of out in the media. So that we did that with traffic risk. We did that with mortality risks. I was also on a National Academy of Sciences panel looking at the unintended acceleration in vehicles. So that was, you probably read on or saw in the news that Toyotas were sort of taking off unexpectedly in unexpected times. So I got to work with, I was one of the two social scientists on the committee, and the rest were engineers, and there was a guy who reconstructs accidents, and there's people who are the engineers looking at electromagnetic interference. And so working with those guys and trying to figure out what was going on with those cars. So we were trying to figure out, first of all, what was going on with those cars and looking at the crash reports. But we were also trying to think about how public policy should address that issue. And so a group of really smart guys with much different backgrounds than me, sort of looking to me for expertise in some cases, which was really, really a great experience. I find myself looking at numbers all the time. In fact, I was quoted in the AP story on the traffic risks. Women are much safer behind the wheel than men. It's just really, no one's safer than a 40-year-old woman, driving a minivan. Basically, that's a good place to be. You don't want to be in a car with a bunch of teenagers, right? The guy asked me, the reporter asked me if I let my wife drive, and I say, I just keep my mouth shut and ride shotgun, and I realize that the statistics are with me on being safer than if I was actually behind the wheel. All men think that, all men think they're safe drivers, but it turns out the numbers just don't back that up. In my intermediate class, which is sort of the truth test class, or the, where the students show their street cred for they want to be economists, every Tuesday we have Coin Toss Tuesday. So I will toss a coin, and if it comes up heads, then their quiz will be graded. And if it comes up tails, it won't be graded. So if you've ever thought that intermediate economics course would be cheering one way or another at 9 o'clock in the morning, you can come by some Tuesday morning and see me toss the coins in class.